All right, y'all. First period, econ. What's today's date, y'all? Okay, Thursday, August 19th, 2021. All right, welcome. Hope y'all feeling all right when y'all watch this later, but please check in with how you feeling. Self-awareness is key. We already did that. Y'all got something to write with? And hopefully one day we get these Chromebooks open so y'all can be able to write it on the Chromebook. But, yeah, can somebody read the do now? The do now. Oh, in blue. It says writing, right? Yeah, the little quote right there, the directions. Well, we also always have paper over there, y'all, and pens always. So you got pins over there. And it says, write a 2-sentence reaction to the quote. And can someone read that quote if you can see it? I know with the different seating arrangement. People often complain about the lack of time when the lack of direction is the problem. Ziglar? Take like 3 minutes and write a 2-sentence reaction to that quote really quickly. Then we'll get started with today's essential question. So for y'all gonna watch this later, the first thing we're doing is we're writing a 2-sentence reaction to this quote, which says, people often complain about the lack of time when the lack of direction is the problem. In 2 sentences. Paper and pen feels fine. Word document is even better. And I understand if you don't have it up yet. It's all good. It's kind of hard to see over here. So 2-sentence reaction, and it's pertaining to this quote right here. It says, can you see it? I guess I could have used that. That's a good synonym. Reaction, relate.
If you don't turn it in yet, we do more writing too. If I haven't said it, really appreciate y'all coming on time. No, it's all right. I mean, you know, part of being successful and professional is being on time. All right, seems like y'all done. Hold on to those, unless you just want to share real quick.
I don't know if it's going to make sense, but I read it.
That's all right.
I said, I feel like this quote is trying to say, people often complain about how much they don't have time to do something, but in reality, they're not putting enough
time into themselves. Mm-hmm. I actually think that should be in the quote. That's your own, that's the Supreme, the Wilson, the last name, that's the Miss Wilson quote. Yes,
it is.
Opportunity what? There we go. All right. My brother, how are we feeling? About this quote. What did you write down? Lack of time. You said it costs more. How'd you phrase it again?
Not having directions is more like time consuming than having directions.
Okay. Yeah, I would agree. Yeah, I like how y'all are
or reflecting off the post.
All right. Can somebody read today's essential question?
What is time management?
Okay. What is time management? I think the other day, Tuesday, we talked about these two from our entrepreneurship aptitude. Mr. Breida, I'm gonna encourage you, okay? Because you be doubting yourself on how you speak sometimes or how you read. And from what I've read so far and what I've seen thus far is that you do both very well. So I want you to believe in yourself that you can speak and you can read and you can write. Yes, you can. All right. Aptitude. Do you remember what that means? We can also cheat. We can cheat. Teacher, it's interesting to see like when different people walk in the room, how the room changes. Some people act different, other people come in the room, and so it's part of our social environment, part of our attitude. One of the things I want to help instill is to be you all day long. Okay, that was the attitude. Yeah, what about the aptitude? What does that mean? How do you relate that to yourself? How do you interpret it? What is your personal synonym for it?
Like you said at first, like when like the teacher walks in and people start acting differently, I think that's also aptitude. It's something that you do naturally.
So the things that like our natural abilities, things we do natural, our gifts, our talents. I can't draw. So y'all taking art, right? Like I'm not a very good drawer. I'm gonna have to work on it in order to improve at it. In the kitchen. My wife has been cooking way longer than me, and so sometimes I have to work really hard to get the recipe right, and she's over there putting stuff in her hand. I'm like, wow!
That was my mom yesterday. He was asking for help, and he tried to turn around, she already doing it.
I'm just saying, she already did it. So, you know, that's what she do. She's a singer. For me, my aptitude is I'm a good listener. And I can pick up on things and do them. People say I'm a fast learner, so I guess that's one of my aptitudes. But I always remember that attitude and aptitude, you know, one affects the other. Attitude definitely affects our aptitude. There's so many people who are so gifted, but because of their attitude, the gifts go to waste. Or they don't fulfill their dreams. They don't do what they want to do. Okay, Mr. A, rambling on. Okay. All right, y'all. Video from this brother, very inspiring to me. In your routine. Just check it out. See what you got to say.
Nothing is permanent. Sit down. Nothing is permanent with that. But if somebody in this room failed this test and you're acting like it's permanent, you talk right now. I'm talking to somebody today like, I'm 25 years old. I have no money, right? I said, okay, and? Did you just hear what I said? I said, what did you just say? I'm broke. I'm about to get evicted from my house. I don't have anything. I said, okay, and? Like, you talking like it's the end of the world. What are you saying? I'm broke. Oh, let's do this. Don't focus on the fact.
are right now is not the end. It's just a transition. All right, let's be honest. How many of y'all get up and you just get your day started? You don't have it written down. You don't have a strategy. You don't have a real plan. You kind of just get up and say, I'm about to tackle today. Raise your hand for me. Raise your hand. We're going to stop. No more of that. Like, you don't go to war without a plan. You just don't come out. Just, I hope I hit somebody. I told y'all, we ain't on that Arnold Schwarzenegger stuff. I'll be back. Just blowing up stuff. We're on that Jason Bourne. We're going to the top floor. We got the scope. I'm being 100. We ain't on it. You just get up to the board. I hit somebody. You just tore up the whole house. I mean, you got my man, but you just tore the whole house up, got some other people in the process. He barely got help you to get up. Strategy. Open up, go, stop, you lay here, go a couple hours. Mission accomplished, you move on. I need you to be strategic. I hear little kids, I want to go to the NBA. Not like that. You just run up and down the court. Not like that, you're not going. No strategy. I want to go to the NFL. You ain't even in school, no? You're not going to the NFL. I want to make millions. You're not even doing what millionaires do. And those of you messed up, why? Because you don't understand. Think, act, eat, rest. So what are we talking about? We're talking about a schedule. I realize that my strength is in my routine. Why? Because I'm not as strong as I thought I was. I'm not as intelligent as I thought I was. I don't want it as bad as I thought I wanted it. It's in my routine. It's what I do every day repeatedly. I just help somebody out. You're struggling because you don't have a routine. You all. You finally got my man after 4 hours. But you messed up everything else in your life. You lost all your friends because you didn't have a schedule. The DNA of your success is in your routine. You're not as deep as you think you are. You got a final routine. I'm getting up at 3 and stick with it. I'm getting up at 5 and stick with it. Yeah, out of 365 days, you have a bad day or two. But I'm trying to tell you, the strength is in the routine. Find a routine and stick with it.
Y'all hear that when he said, what was the main thing he kept saying over and over again? I have it written up there, too.
Success is in your routine.
Success is in your routine. Thank you, Ms. Sabrina. Success is in your routine. All right. What 4 things did he say was important in order... in our routine, what we have to do. 4 things. They're written up here on the board, too. Think, act, eat, and rest. My question is, are we doing that? I feel you, Sabrina, we got to grab what we could this morning. Got to eat something. Because I don't have no energy to do anything. I may crash a little bit later. Hopefully I can eat something better. But, so we're about to think. Are we thinking about our day before we get up? Are we planning out our day? Are we planning out our week? Planning out our month? And then once we plan it out, we act on it. Okay, but without the other two,
without putting any nourishment in our bodies, without any rest, it's gonna be hard to act and think. All right? Success is in the routine. Success is in the routine. So again, we put out another piece of media up, and with your pen, pencil, and paper, I want you to write down just three of the suggestions that this person has about time management. Okay.
Here's some ideas on how to structure your day for maximum productivity, performance, and output. Many from Facebook recently asked me, how do you structure your day? So here's some tips to help you structure your day to be more productive and successful. Number one, every minute spent in planning saves 10 minutes in execution or getting the job done. So
write that down, y'all, put 10 to 1. 10 to 1. 10 to 1.
Recently asked me, how do you structure your day? So here's some tips to help you structure your day to be more productive and successful. Number one, every minute spent in planning saves 10 minutes in execution or getting the job done.
Okay, let's just stop right there. Yeah, 10 to 1. So what is he? We heard it, but let's interpret it for ourselves so we can take it out the classroom and out there. So 10 to 1, what is he saying? One minute of planning. Okay. Let's say for how many minutes?
1 minute of planning. Helps you get your
day started. Our day started, and it, how many minutes would we say?
10.
Okay. It's according to some research that he found out.
So the most important thing you can do is plan your day, preferably the night before. Sit down with a piece of paper and write down everything that you have to do the coming day. It should be the last thing you do at the end of the day. Now, if for any reason you don't do this, then the first thing you do in the morning, before you check your email, your phone calls, newspapers, first thing you do in the morning is make a list of everything that you have to do that day. Once you have a list, you have a track to run on. Writing down a list clarifies your thinking. Writing down a list forces you to think at a higher level. If you start working from a list, you increase your productivity and output by 25% the first day. All successful people work from lists, and all successful people, with regard to their projects, work from checklists. A checklist is a list of everything organized in sequence, and you go down the checklist. Now, the second way that you can organize your day is to set priorities on your list before you begin. Don't just rush into it. Look over the list and apply the 80-20 rule. If you have 10 items to do on your list, 2 will be more valuable than the other 8 put together.
Okay, but what is this guy saying? He's saying a whole bunch of stuff. Okay, so we've got the 10 to 1 rule. So for every 1 minute in planning that we do, we save ourselves 10 minutes. And now what is he talking about? Okay, making a list. So on 10 things on the list, we're just going to do, let's see, today, Mr. A, I got to teach, but I also got to set up the Google Classroom. What is more important at the moment right now? Be prepared for the class. But in the back of my mind, I'm like, as soon as I get a minute, y'all writing your exit ticket in between the next class, maybe at lunch, I can't go out there today. I gotta get some stuff done. So I have to prioritize getting my work done over, you know, spending time with my peers this afternoon. But for y'all, what does it mean for you, especially in your business endeavors that y'all got going on? The things that y'all want to do, want to create, your entrepreneur ideas, the tattooing shops, you know, musician, you know? Okay, so he said something that starts with the letter P. in mind, we'll write about it later.
Sometimes it's the 90-10 rule. If you have 10 items on your list, one will be important, more important than all the others put together. Go down your list and ask yourself this question. If I could only do one thing on this list before I was called out of town for a month, what one task would I want to be sure to complete? Now, in my life, I'm called out of town for a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, sometimes a month, all the time. Last fall, I was out of town and traveling in 15 countries over 36 days. So I have to look at my work list before I go, and I have to get my most important tasks done. So once you identify this task, that leads to the next way to organize your day.
Okay, so if we could do that really quickly, y'all, on your, always that paper back there, and something to write with, but on your paper, we're not going to do 10. Can we do let's do it half. Can we do five? Top five priorities in your life right now. Just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You don't have to put it in a sentence or anything like that. Just take about 2 minutes. Just write down our top five priorities. As I just bullet points, fine. Right under your do now earlier. And I guess Annabelle, so you can get those points too for the do now. It was anybody remember the quote from the do now? It was people often complain about lack of time when the lack of direction is the problem. So anywhere on your paper, you know, put do now. It's just two sentences. And for y'all watching this later, the do now, and we're doing 5 top priorities. So when you're watching this later, please you send it to Mr. A. 5 top priorities. Okay.
Is begin immediately on your most important task, and then stay with it until it's complete.
And that's the last thing that y'all do. I'll put a star next to the one that is the most important. The thing that we need to prioritize the most.
All of success in life comes from project completion. It comes from taking jobs, and a project is called a multitask job. It means there's several little jobs within the larger job. And what you do is you organize your projects by sequence, the checklist, and then you start on your most important project, and then you stay with that project until it's complete.
I got to stop it right there because sometimes, has anybody ever worked on a large project, something that takes can't just do it in 5 minutes, 10 minutes, or even one day? Okay, you want to share with us? That's what we're going to do in here. By the time week 10 come around, we're going to have a big project. Everything that we're doing now is building upon it, okay? But that's why, was everyone here for the life map when we wrote about our early life. I think some of us were talking about how we were raised by mostly our siblings. Some of us talked about how we used to be shy. But we're going to be using our early life experiences to write out our own life map, our own, a book about our own life. But being able to break up large projects into smaller projects, that is a skill. It is a skill.
This process is called single handling. It's the most powerful success strategy that you can use in managing your time. You can actually increase your productivity by 50% by simply starting and completing your most important task first thing every day. So if you can do those three things, start with a list, organize the list by priority, and then start on and complete your most important task, you can double and triple your productivity, sometimes almost overnight. Thanks for listening. This is Brian Tracy on Success Talk. Did you like this episode? Make sure to subscribe for the next.
Can we hear those? Let me write mine down too. That was too long. Okay, my top one. Let's see. Health. The five I'm gonna go with for myself. Health is probably the most important thing to me, because without that, I can't get money. I gotta be able to be, if I don't have my health, it's gonna be hard to invest time with my family, it's gonna be hard to do my occupation as a teacher. And then when I finally have a little free time for myself, I ain't gonna be able to do my hobby either without health. So that's Mr. A's list. Can I hear y'all top five real quick? Very important. Thanks, y'all. Take turns reading Increasing Your Potential. I'll read the first one. And all this has to do with being an entrepreneur. So whatever your interest is, your entrepreneurial interest, this is
steps to increasing our capacity to be able to be an entrepreneur. Increase your business and entrepreneurial potential by focusing on 6 specific areas, okay? Business knowledge, I don't know what kind of business you into. I have no idea. I do because I'll be reading stuff. But reading magazines and newspaper articles, search the internet, and probably the most important one is this one, and talk to business owners. If you want to get into a tattooing business, do we talk to owners of tattoo shops? That would be an important relationship to make. Maybe next time we go get a tattoo or something, the person doing it, how you start this? Okay? Financial skills. Strengthen your math skills. Strengthen your math skills. In order to become a teacher, we got to pass like basic arithmetic tests. It took me 4 times. I did good on the reading, I did good on the writing, but because my math skills were not up to par, I had to end up taking a class. I had to invest 2 Saturdays. I had to get up in the morning on Saturday after my long work week. The class started at 8 o'clock to 12. And because of the tools that they taught us in that class, I was able to pass, finally, the CBES math test. So, strengthen your math skills. Career, I'm reading it. Hey, somebody else read this one. Career exploration. I'm sorry. Not really. Pretty soon, we want to start printing this stuff out. Y'all just have it. Okay. I'm trying to find a way to get all the words on the screen. Try your best. Let's try your best. Career exploration.
Okay. What kind of career
do you want to do? How you want to make your money? What about someone to read community awareness? Oh, this some of the words are blocked off. Alright, there we go. I apologize if it's too small. I think someone could read community awareness. If you have, I know everybody don't have time to volunteer, but if you could learn a whole lot, especially in the field that you want to go into, okay, nursing, social welfare, social work. This one, y'all doing this now? I'm gonna read education.
Personally, you personally, and open doors to
we just be a social worker? Like, I just want to be a social worker. What do we have to do? We have to get some education. And, I know that for social workers, sometimes people are going into homes and the way the children are living, it really hurts the social worker's heart. But you have to go by the book in order to get the child out of the home, or in order to help the caretakers really, really care for the children. Okay, it's a lot of stepping back you have to do too. All right, and can someone read relationships besides Sabrina? Please. We're doing that. We're not spending our time with people who are going to stab us in the back, but the people who are going to inspire us to actually get to our goals, to get to our entrepreneurial goals. Okay?
Oh, 10-10. I think we have 8 minutes, y'all.
Can we read this before we do our exit ticket? I'll read the first one, though. Okay, why study entrepreneurship? There are two primary reasons why studying entrepreneurship makes sense. You learn to think like an entrepreneur, and you develop a vision for your life. Okay. Can someone read? Think like an entrepreneur, observe and listen. Say it again. And again, I do apologize for. Can someone read the one on the left hand side? Someone else, can we read about think and vision? And I know some of the font is making it hard to read, so I understand.
Think, don't complain about a problem, analyze it, and suggest possible solutions. Learning about
entrepreneurship. That's priceless, having a vision for our lives. Okay. All right, get to the exit ticket. We out of here. Can someone read the exit ticket real quick? Our aptitude and attitude related to time management for you. 5 sentences, y'all. Y'all reading today and participating. And if hopefully remember aptitude, it means our natural ability. Our natural ability. And our attitude is the way we think about it. You know? How do those come together with time management for you? And for those who are going to be watching this later, the exit ticket is how our aptitude and attitude related to time management for you.
5 sentences. Thank you.